It's our year-end review with the soccer program here at South Dakota State. Head coach Brock Thompson along with us. And Brock, first and foremost, let's just begin with how you talk to your team after what happens, because you have this unbelievable season, so much excitement, a ton of accomplishments, and a lot of things to celebrate. Yet, as the nature of athletics go, you're going to sometimes end your season in a loss, and that can, in the moment, put clouds over a lot of things. So how do you balance everything and celebrate what you accomplished, knowing the disappointment of how things ended?
Yeah, it was a tough conversation, to be honest with you, Tyler. And I think that I didn't have a lot of words. I was very, very honest in the fact that said, you know, we can say a lot of things. We can say that we didn't deserve for our season to end this way. We deserved better. The truth of it is, and this is the message that I hope they took away from what I said, is there will be a point where we can look back on this season and be very, very proud. Because it was a remarkable fall. And and the team deserved a little bit more than kind of how it ended too. And but I told them I loved them, I told them I'm proud of them, and I told them that the result on the scoreboard is never going to change those two things.
Well, again, you look back at the regular season, and when you play an entire season and don't actually lose a game, I mean, that's phenomenal. I know it's something we didn't talk about a lot during the year, partially because we don't want an announcer's jinx or anything like that. But you stop and think, you're the only Division I team that didn't actually suffer a loss during the regular season.
Yeah, it's special, it's remarkable, and you know, and the consistency that our team played at, you know, all through, including the game in the conference tournament, the difference from our best to kind of the off day or the off game or the off half was very narrow, and that's remarkable, and that's something that I'm very proud of. We played, you combine that with probably playing the most difficult schedule we've played in a while. You know, I think we'll end up with having played four or five games against the top, the top 100 RPI. And to do that, I think you have to credit two things. We have remarkable leadership, both from our COVID seniors or our bonus seniors or whatever you want to call them, but from our captain and Maya Hansen as well. But all the way through, and even people that found their own way to lead, whether it was the energy on the bench or behind the scenes, you can't have consistent success without really solid leadership, and that's something that probably wasn't seen to outsiders this year.
You have to have leadership. You have to have exceptional players, and you have a few that come to mind, some headliners. You mentioned Maya Hansen is one of them. But the thing that stood out to me was it wasn't two or three players. I mean, it really was a team effort, and every week we'd sit here and talk about somebody else that maybe hadn't been on the scoreboard the last few weeks, then comes up with two goals in a game or makes a huge defensive play. There were a number of key contributors throughout the course of the year.
Without a doubt. And I think, you know, even through the course of the season, we played a number of games without some key players, whether that's Maya, Avery Merzek, Carly, Casey, missed a little bit of time from that. And to do that, I think that there has to be a culture that the team comes first. And I think when you talk about leadership and you talk about our team culture, the connectedness is that it's the team first. And when it's your opportunity, you have to deliver your best. And when there's a sense of, when there's a desire to deliver your best for the team, that's when special things happen. And there were so many little moments that popped up that that reflected that. One of them that happened on Sunday was I felt like Abigail Castens and Jenna Holland play added some great energy at the end of the first half, and really kind of maybe spurred on the second half performance by how they how they came into the game and changed it at the end of the first half.
And let's give a special nod to Jackrabbit Nation, the fan base, because part of your success at home was because of that turnout. Had a great crowd again on Sunday for that Summit League semifinal. I mean, what this fan base has done rallying around your program is nothing short of impressive.
It's so thankful to the community and Jackrabbit Nation and really SDSU and the administration and the whole university is, you know, our team and our program feels very, very much loved and valued from all of those entities, and we're really grateful. I also feel like, I feel like so many people got the chance to get to know our program a little bit this year, whether that was directly through conversations with some of our players or just by connecting with it. And I think, our players are wonderful ambassadors to SDSU and Jackrabbit Athletics, and the more people that know that, the better For sure. And I felt just really, really, really proud of the connection their team continues to make with the community. And I think it showed on game day in the stands and in that Fishback.
All right, so here we are. The season just ended, and yet I know you're already thinking to the spring and thinking to next year because that's how a coach's mind is wired. So what's the next step here? What's to look forward to for Jackrabbit Soccer?
Yeah, you know, next Wednesday we'll have signing day, and so we'll welcome some of our incoming players next Wednesday. We'll go through kind of an evaluation with our current players and have some individual meetings and team, and then we'll go through a period of time where we kind of rest and recharge, both coaches and players, of the ability to kind of refocus. And in the spring is always a very important time for us developmentally, and that's always our focus. And so we'll take this time to kind of plan what that looks like, plan ways for us to continue to get better. The phrase I often use with myself and the team is, is whatever happens is in our best interest and an opportunity to learn and grow. And we can use this time to evaluate how do we learn and grow, how do we become better, and that's holistically. That's not just winning more games. That's how do we become a better team. How do we become a more connected team? And certainly, we're not a program or a team that's broken by any means. But but it's also a time where we ask our players to have growth mindsets throughout the full year, and us as coaches have to demonstrate that during this kind of planning time too.